So I started thinking about this problem by considering the opening moves. But there are lots of things that multiply to give a million, and it seemed hard to get a grasp on. So I started thinking then about the ending moves. And like lots of strategy problems, this turns out to be a fruitful area to explore. So let's think about how the game could end. It's only going to end when either Rianne or Jack can't write down another number. And that means that they can't find distinct A and B that go into the number that is written on the board. And that's only going to happen when the number written on the board is 1. We cannot find distinct A and B. And so if either Rianne or Jack write down the number 1, they have won. So 1 is a winning position. Now, if anybody writes down the number 2, then the only way that that can be factorised is into 2 and 1. And either way round, that means the next number is going to be 1. So that means that 2 is a losing position. If you write down 2, you have lost the game. And we can carry on with this analysis. If somebody writes down 3, the next person is going to have to write down 2. And we know that that's a losing position. The next person is going to have to write down 1, and they have won. When we get to 4, we can't do 2 and 2 because they're not distinct. So we'll have to do 4 and 1. And that means we have to write down 3. And we've already seen that that leads to 2 and 1. So 4 is a losing position. We can carry on. 5 is not so interesting. It gets a little bit more interesting when we get to 6, because we could either do 3 and 2, which means that we would write down 1. And so 6 is a losing position there. But alternatively, we could do 6 and 1 and write down 5. And then 5 would have to be 5 and 1, forces the next person to write down 4. And we know that 4 is a losing position. So 6 is also a losing position, either way that we do it. OK, let's just summarise what we found. So we found that if you write down the number 1, you win. But it's also true that if you write down 3 or 5, you win. And if you write down the number 2, you lose. And the same is true for 4 and 6. So it looks suspiciously like you win if you write down an odd number. Well, is it possible that one player could always write down an odd number? Let's see. The first player could use the factorisation a million times 1. And that would enable them to write down an odd number. And once an odd number is on the board, that means that the next player is unable to write down an odd number because they will have to choose 2 odd factors and they have the same parity. And so the next number they write down will be an even number. So then player 1 is then faced with an even number again. And given any even number, you can always do 1 times itself and that will give you an odd number to write down. So the first player is able to constantly write down an odd number every single time. They're guaranteed to be faced with an even number and they're able to write down an odd number. That means that the first player will be able to get to 1. They know for sure that the second player, who is forced to always write even numbers, will never get to 1. So there is a winning strategy and it is for the first player.